Welcome back to Katia's Buzz. Today I'm going to show you how you can turn a flat flyer into a 3D fold using Photoshop perspective warp. First thing you need to do is bring in your flyer. Then you need to find something that has the shape that you want. You select around it, you bring the layer on top so you know exactly where you want your flyer to fold. And then you quickly go into edit perspective warp. And I'll show you exactly how you fold it. Let me know what you think of perspective warp and how quickly you can turn things around. I hope you've been using this tool. If you haven't already done so, please jump into Photoshop, check it out. You can do a million different things with it. It's super easy and it's an incredibly powerful tool. Now that you know the basics of what needs to happen, let me take you through it step by step because it's really an easy process. But if you don't know too much about Photoshop, I'm going to take you through it. All right, so let's go back to the very beginning. We have a blank screen. We're going to bring in our flat flyer. I'm gonna make a copy. I'm gonna drag it here, hide this one. As you can see, it's already a smart object. This is my flyer. So we are going to make sure that we know exactly what we want at the end. In order to do that, I browsed on the internet. I found something that looked more or less like what I wanted to create. And so I found this. All right, so as you see, I have created a shape here. If you don't know how to do that, you see the design in the back. You go here to your lasso tool, polygonal lasso tool, and you click on every extremity. Up, 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 up. And when you're done, you see it creates a little circle. That means it closes your shape. I'm going to create a new layer. And in that layer, I'm going to left click and say stroke. I'm going to use a bright red so I see it on top of my design. And I'm going to do 5. I'm going to do it outside. And that creates this nice red line for me. So I'm going to bring it to the top. If your layer is at the bottom, you want to make sure you bring it all the way to the top because you want it to be on top of all the other layers you're about to create. Now we're going to close this and I'm going to lock this layer. Now, my layer here is flat. As you can see, I have the shape on top. It's locked, so it's not going to bother me. My layer is here. So I'm going to make a copy. I always make copies. This way I never destroy the original. If I make a mistake, I just go back to the previous layer. It's a habit I have. All right, so now we're ready to fold our flyer. So you select a flat version of your flyer and you go to edit, perspective warp. Then you're going to split your flyer in 3. So you see here, I'm going to do panel number 1. I'm going to start panel number 2 from here. You make sure that you connect the dots here so that it creates just one single shape together. And then my third panel is going to be over here. You make sure the circles are on top of one another. The reason you do that is you see it's only one. And that's really important. You want it to be just one shape. If it doesn't work together, you just take the dot and you bring it back so that they link together. So now we have 3 panels. You're gonna come and click on warp and you're just going to pick each part and bring it here, puff, tack. You bring it over here, you bring it over here, you bring each one where you want it to be. And it's really helpful to have that shape because otherwise I wouldn't really know where I put my dots. So this really makes it easy for me to know where the angles go. Okay, it's finished. From there on, I can remove this. I can come here and create a drop shadow. Okay, you see the shadow just came here. If you learned anything in this video, make sure you press like and subscribe to my channel. To make it a little bit prettier, I brought in the flat version again. I just cut the part. I turned it a little bit just to bring it, to make it a little bit more attractive. And then here, I just brought a gradient. And if you don't know how to do a gradient, you just create a layer, come here, gradient tool, and then you can do whatever gradient you want. And you have here on your gradients a lot of different choices. You have all the greens. Now I happen to like the dark grays, see black. And pretty much, this is what I wanted to show you. In a few minutes, you're able to create a folded three-fold flyer in 3D, and now you can post it on your social media. I hope this was a nice trick for you. I hope you learned something. Let me know what you think of this tutorial, and please come back next week. I'll have something else for you. Have a beautiful rest of the day. Happy holiday, and see you soon.